one of the things that happened when I got to the fence. It's just such an overwhelming amount of blood, you know? And we try to wear protective gloves, but he was a really cheap sheriff at the time, and he just bought us shit gloves, you know? And you put them on, and you put them on, and they just keep breaking. So finally you run out of gloves. So I just kept thinking, you know, don't hesitate. You know, your mind is always telling you, don't hesitate. And so you keep moving, and you try to help Anthony, and you try to find an airway. That's what you do, you know?
What I didn't tell you before is that Reggie's my daughter.
Marge Murray.
And when she told me she first wanted to be a police officer, well, I thought there wasn't a better job for her. You know, she could handle whatever came her way.
About a day and a half later, the hospital called me. Told me that Matthew had HIV. And I'd been exposed. I had bad exposure because I'd been building a lean-to for my llamas, and my hands had all these open cuts on them. I was kind of screwed, you know? Just keep thinking, oh shoot, you know?
Would you like to talk about losing sleep?
So I said to the doctor, okay, what do I do? And they said, get up here. And so I got up there, and we started the ATZ drugs immediately.
Now that's a drug that they said if you take it 36 hours after you've been exposed, you can maybe stop yourself from getting the disease.
That is a mean, nasty medicine. Mean. I've lost 10 pounds and a lot of my hair.
And quite frankly, I wanted to lash out at somebody. Not Matthew. Please understand, not one of us is mad at Matthew. But I maybe wanted to squeeze McKinney's head off. And I think about Henderson. You know, two absolutely human beings cause so much pain for so many people. It's been terrible for my whole family, but mostly for her and her kids.
I think it finally brought home to my girls what their mom does for a living.
Well, Reggie, you know what I'm going to tell you now.
My parents, you know. My parents told me the same damn thing.
You're quitting this damn job!
It's just a parent thing, you know? They're incredibly proud of you, whether you're handling a drunk or handling a case like this, but yeah, they just don't want you getting hurt.
Like I said, there's a right way, there's a wrong way, and there's Reggie's way.
So finally I said, for God's sakes, lighten up, Francis.
You're so stubborn!
I say I'm stubborn, but I don't believe. You know, I just keep thinking, okay, that's your opinion. Now here's mine. I'm 39 years old, what are they gonna do, spank me?
Reggie, don't give me any ideas.
It looked pretty funny. You know, what can they say?
I just hope she doesn't go before me.